Hey kids, it's Papa. Are you ready to explore the Bible? All right. Take your Bibles and turn with me to Joshua chapter 14. Joshua chapter 14. Now remember that Israel went and they came across the Jordan River, conquered Jericho, conquered Ai, made an unfortunate league with Gibeon, and then all of the kings in the south said, "Hey, let's get together and go against them." They did, and Israel was able to conquer and destroy all of the cities to the south. And then the kings up north said, "Hey, we're stronger. We ought to do that." So they all got together and they met up here. And sure enough, Israel went and conquered them and caught them while they were sleeping and chased them all over in their pajamas and chased them back to their cities and destroyed them. And the entire conquest of Jericho took about 5 years. So it took quite a long time, but it was worth it. And so they're all conquered. And in chapter 12 and chapter 13, chapter 12 talks about all of the 31 kings that they killed and all of their nations that they killed. And then chapter 12 and 13 talk about all of the cities and how they divided the kingdom. How they divided the nation amongst all of the different tribes. But there's an interesting story in Joshua chapter 14. And turn there with me, if you will. Joshua chapter 14. We're going to start in verse 6. Now remember, back when they first came, now this was 45 years earlier, when they first came to Kadesh Barnea, and they sent those 12 spies into the land. And they came back, and you remember 12 men went to spy on Canaan, 10 were bad and 2 were good. Well, who were those 2 good ones? One of them was Joshua. Who was the other one? Do you remember? Do you remember? It was Caleb. Yeah, Caleb. And God said, "All of you people who said we won't go in, you're going to die in the wilderness as you wander in the wilderness for 40 years. And they wandered in the wilderness for 40 years and they all died. And the only 2 that didn't die were Joshua and Caleb. Yeah. Now Joshua was the general. He was in charge and he led everybody in. And you don't hear anything about Caleb until Joshua chapter 14. Now note, look at verse 6. It says, "Then the children of Judah came unto Joshua in Gilgal, and Caleb the son of Jephthah the Kenzanite said unto him, 'Thou knowest the thing that the Lord said unto Moses, the man of God, concerning me and thee in Kadesh Barnea. 40 years old was I when Moses, the servant of the Lord, sent me from Kadesh Barnea to spy out the land, and I brought him word again as it was in my heart.'" Okay, do you see what he's saying here? He's saying, you know what, I was 40 years old and we went into the land, and Moses made some promises to me. And all of our brethren said, "We can't go in." But Joshua, you and I stood up and said, "Hey, we can. These people are bread for us. We're going to eat them up and they're going to make us stronger." But Israel chose not to go in, and you know what happened. He says, "But now," notice verse 9, "Moses swore to me on that day, surely the land wherein thy feet have trodden shall be thine inheritance and thy children's forever, because thou hast wholly followed the Lord thy God." Caleb says, it's been 45 years, 40 years of wandering the wilderness, 5 years of conquering the land. And he says, "You know what? I am just as strong today as I was 45 years ago." Now think about that one for a moment. This would have made him just a couple of years younger than my grandpa, your great grandpa, you know, James Russell, right? Yeah, just dad, right? It's only, yeah, my dad, your dad's grandpa, your great grandpa, yeah. In any case, he was old, and yet he was still strong, ready to fight. And he said, now, and I want you to take a look at verse 12, because this is cool, because we even have a song about this. Notice verse 12. He says, "Now therefore, give me this mountain, therefore, whereof the Lord spake unto me that day. For thou heardest in that day how that the Anakims were there, and that the cities were great and fenced. And if so be that the Lord will be with me, that I shall be able to drive them out, as the Lord said. You know what he's saying here? He was saying, remember all those giants they were talking about? Well, those giants lived in that city on the top of that mountain. And I said, Lord, I want that mountain. And the Lord said, I'm going to give it to you. And now here's 45 years later, and Caleb says, I want that mountain. You know what? It is a neat thing when we take seriously the promises of God. When we hear the word of God and we hear the promises and we say, you know what? I am going to hold God to that promise because he made that promise to me. And so I am going to strive to see that promise fulfilled in my life. And that's what Caleb did. And he remembered the promise of God. I believe that God is honored when we remind him of his promises. Remember that. God is honored when we remind him of his promises. And that's what Caleb did. And so Caleb said, I want that mountain. And Joshua said, you know what? It's yours. Go get it. Now, in order to get it, he had to go conquer those people up there. And they were giants. But what did he do? He took the promise of God. He got his men together and they went up there and they conquered those people. They destroyed them and they took that mountain. And God was honored because Caleb claimed the promise of God. And so I want you to remember that. Also, I want you to remember that they named the city Hebron. Now, it was Kirjath Arba. You know, it means the four of Arba. There were apparently three sons, and the Bible tells us about those three sons, and the father would have made four, and so that's why they called it Kirjath Arba. But he said, nope, no longer. We're not remembering them giants. We're going to call it Hebron. And so that's what they changed the name to, Hebron, H-E-B-R-O-N. Anyway, so that's today. And I hope you were listening closely, because both of the answers to the questions are in what I just said. If you didn't get it, go back and listen again. Yeah. All right. Hey, love you guys. See you soon. Bye-bye.